Want to know what type of shooting you should be practicing to score more goals? Then stick around for the finishing mindset in soccer. Hey, I'm Dylan Joseph, soccer trainer and number one best-selling Amazon book author. To overcome years of average performances and increase your self-esteem, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon. And stick around to the end of this video for a pro tip on exactly how to apply this mindset in your game. Today, we're covering the one type of shooting you must be practicing. First, when it comes to which type of shooting you should use, you gotta understand the 80-20 principle. The 80-20 rule, also known as the Pareto principle, is that 80% of the results that you get are from 20% of the things that you do. In soccer, roughly 20% of your habits have 80% of the impact on your performance. Most players weigh everything equally in their minds as well as in what they practice. Sadly, players care more about the cool foot skills, the super powerful shot, than they do being able to play a perfect 10-yard pass to the correct foot, or to play a pass that allows their teammates to run onto it, or to be able to receive a pass that allows them to take an attacking touch and set up for an easy shot or pass and layoff and assist to a teammate. I'll be completely honest when I say that I fell into the same trap in my early years of high school soccer as well. The things that I practiced the most was my shot with the ball stop, tons and tons of foot skills that, because I practiced so many, I'd never actually be able to use in a game. But my nutrition was on point and I worked out and lifted about 5 to 6 days a week, so I thought that those were super important. Sadly, because I couldn't effectively receive a pass near the net or dribble past an opposing player, I didn't get many chances in order to score. Next, let us discuss scoring in soccer. There are many ways to score in soccer, but only a few of the ways will provide the most goals throughout your playing career. In the image, notice that 80% of soccer players' goals on average will come from either the driven shot or the bent shot. Only 20% of the goals that a soccer player scores on average will come from pass shots, headers, trivellas, toe pokes, bicycle kicks, heel shots, or goals from other parts. Therefore, most of your time should be spent on perfecting the driven shot and the bent shot. And could you give this video a like? Now, let us consider a teammate of mine that went to play for a D1 college, went on to play professionally for Waza Flow Pro, and is now a coach of a college team. Joey was an all-state forward who scored nearly 30 goals on only his junior season of varsity soccer. During halftime at one of our high school soccer games, he actually pulled me aside and he said, "Honestly, I just practiced the same few skills over and over again and they seemed to work." I was unwise at the time because I thought his advice was bad. I thought you had to practice a ton of skills instead of just focus on a few key ones. If a player only ever practices and uses 4 foot skills, you better believe they're going to become fantastic at those 4 skills. Sadly, I was a jack of all trades and a master of none. And because I could do each one decently well, that when I use them in a game, sometimes they'd work and sometimes they didn't, but I'd get frustrated because they weren't consistent. And regrettably, I didn't take his advice for the next couple years and I kept practicing those jab steps, scissors, self passes, rolls, shot fakes, elasticos, 3 directions, rainbows, you name it, I practiced it. I was a jack of all trades, but a master of none. And sadly, when you go to use skills that you haven't mastered, they're generally not gonna work for you in a game. This leads to a ton of frustration for that soccer player who's practicing a ton of hours, but isn't really seeing any advancement with any of their skills because they're practicing so many different things. With his 4 skills, Joey kept scoring. Me, with my 12 plus skills, none of which really worked, I found it very frustrating and hard to even be able to get a shot off, something that you really need to do if you're looking to score at least a goal or two per game. To learn more about this topic, grab the book Soccer Mindset using the link below. So, those key areas that you should be spending the majority of your practice time are passing the ball 10 plus yards without error, knowing exactly how to use an attacking touch, learning the big 3 foot skills, learning how to take a driven shot, and knowing where to push the opposing player while defending. So, make sure to subscribe to avoid missing the next weekly video on what you should be doing before your game that will make you 2 times as good without even touching a ball. So click the top video to learn about mental toughness in soccer, or click the bottom video if you want to learn how to shoot a driven shot.